Raspberry Lemonade from Country Time.
Attention Medicare recipients. Are you having respiratory problems or breathing difficulties? Not getting relief from your breathing medications? Do you use Proventil or Albuterol, Atrovent, Combivent, or other breathing medications? Did you know if you qualify, Medicare can cover breathing medications that are already pre-mixed? Call Med4Home to discuss Medicare requirements. Call us now at 1-800-741-9489.
It's time for Love Hollywood Style on Tattletales. Then catch a spousal slugfest on Classic Newlywed Game, followed by Card Sharks. Hey, now you can play along with Win TV from your own PC. Register to play at GameShowNetwork.com, download the free software, then log on weekdays at 12 p.m. Eastern to watch, play, and win. Win TV Interactive, where a classic game show meets the future.
Goodson Bill Todman Production. Television City in Hollywood, it's Card Sharks. Here's the host of Card Sharks, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Thank you, and hello, everybody. Welcome to Card Sharks. Glad you could be with us today because we have two very delightful contestants. They're in the middle of their second game. We'll tell you all about that in just a moment. But first of all, I want you to meet our two lovely dealers on Card Sharks, and here they are, Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams. This is it. Our champ is back. We'll see what happens today. Let's deal those cards out. We'll pick it up, like I say, from where we left off yesterday. Susanna will be dealing the red cards on the top row for our champion, Robert, while Lacey deals the cards on the bottom row for our challenger. And while they're doing that, let's meet our two card sharks. Here they come now.
How do you do?
Boy, don't you look spiffy today.
Well, I've been out spending your money.
You've been out spending our money, I see.
Well, sure, I earned it.
Well, you look very nice. Yesterday you were a little collegiate. Today you look very spiffy.
Well, I'm older today.
Are you really? Older than yesterday?
Yes.
You're also richer. You got $8,800 as our champion so far.
Good for me. I love it.
In case there's anybody out there that does not know who you are, tell them.
I am Robert Brissett from the great metropolis of Menominee, Michigan. 8,000 sleepy souls. And I brought my wife with me because she didn't trust me here alone. But I've been married to her 50 and a half years.
I know why you take her everywhere you go. You don't want to kiss her goodbye.
Oh, yes, I do.
Oh, you do, huh?
Yes, I do.
Well,
I like to kiss
here.
Her hello, too.
Is that right? You're a nice man, and thanks for being here. And I want you to say hello to our challenge over here. Hi, Sandra. How are you?
Hi. My name is Sandra Chandler Smith. I live in Orange County with my husband, and we're expecting our first baby in 3 months.
You say congratulations, by the way.
Thank you.
Sandra Chandler Smith.
Chandler Smith.
Chandler. That was your maiden name?
Chandler, yeah.
Chandler. So you're going to hang on to it?
Well, I didn't want to be Smith.
What's the matter being Smith?
I thought no one would believe me. You know, if you go in a hotel and you go, oh, I'm Sandra Smith, they go, oh, yeah, okay.
You're absolutely right about that. Okay, I know you cut the cards before the show. Now, the object of our game is to work your way across the board by predicting whether each card is going to be higher or lower than the one preceding it. And as you can see, we had already started game number two. Robert won the first game. Sandra, you got to win this game to stay in. It's the first player to win two games that wins the match and goes on to play the big money cards. So, we're ready. We're in game number two, and this is the second high-low question of the game. Is that correct? Fine. Then, Robert, it's yours. We surveyed 100 women over the age of 65. This ought to be right down your alley, big guy. And we asked them, is it okay for a girl to go back to a guy's place after a first date? How many senior citizen women said that it's okay for a girl to go to the guy's place after a first date?
Right away, the average woman that age is going to be thinking about her girl going back to that guy's place.
Yeah.
And I don't think very many of them are going to okay that at all.
You don't?
No, I don't.
How many out of 100?
Out of 100, not over 22.
Pretty liberal, those 22, then, aren't they?
Yes, okay. They are.
Sandra, do you think the actual number is going to be higher or lower than 22? These are senior citizen women who said it's okay for a girl to go back to a guy's place after the first date.
Well, I know they're probably thinking of it as a positive. We'll go back to his place and we'll play dominoes or something like that. So I think it'll be higher than that.
That's how you got pregnant, wasn't it?
Nice.
The actual number of senior citizen women who said it's okay for a girl to go back to the guy's place after the first date is 25. You're right, it was just a little bit higher. All right, Sandra, now, the five is yours if you want it, or you can change it because you won the high-low question.
I'll change that card.
Well, change the five. Okay, your new card now is a 10. And now you gotta play.
Okay, lower.
Lower than the 10, it is a 4.
Higher.
Higher than the 4, it's a jack.
Lower.
Lower than the jack, it's a 4.
Higher.
Come on to win game number 2. Yeah! The lady wins.
She done good.
Boy, she did. Yes, indeed. All right.
Now we got one going.
Boy, they were just rolling real good for you that time. That's wonderful. So Robert has one game. Sandra has one game. That means we must play our tiebreaker game. And Susanna's going to deal out new cards now from the same deck. Only if you'll notice, only 3 cards in the tiebreaker game with a maximum of 3 high-low questions. Best of luck to you. Will it be Robert or will it be Sandra who plays the big money cards? Let's find out. Sandra, for you. We surveyed 100 bachelors and we asked them, would you trust a divorced woman who admitted she had been unfaithful to her husband? How many bachelors said that they would trust her anyway?
Well, I believe men have kind of big egos, and if you're going out with a guy, he'd probably think, oh, she would be faithful to me, because they think that they were so great. So I think that number will probably be around 65.
65 out of 100 bachelors said they would trust her anyway. Mm-hmm. Let's see what Robert says. Robert, higher or lower than 65?
I was never a bachelor going out with that kind of
woman. You were born married, weren't you?
Yes.
I knew that.
Yeah, she raised me.
She did.
Right. But I think it's a lower figure.
Lower than 65? Bachelors said they would trust her anyway? The actual number of bachelors who would trust a divorced woman who admitted she had been unfaithful is 27. You're right, Robert, it was lower. Okay, Robert, tiebreaker game. Win this game, you play the big money cards again, and here's your base. It's an 8. You can change it.
I'll change it.
I don't blame you. The 8 turns into a 10.
That's lower.
Lower than the 10. Your card is a 6.
Higher.
For the championship, if it's higher than the 6, yes.
Bingo!
There you go again, Robert. Oh, God. Cassandra. You end up with $100. We have some nice prizes for you. Good luck with the new baby. You're a very pretty lady, and thanks for being with us, okay?
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Come here, champ. Boy, you got all dressed up today, and now we're going to play the big money. Turn around, I want to see you.
Sure.
You do look spiffy. You really look nice. We're going to give him a chance to win thousands of dollars. Maybe we can get him to buy a new coat if he wins all that money. We'll see what happens when we come back right after this.
Name an hour in the day when you can see both Richard Dawson and Ray Combs on Family Feud.
Survey said.
Our survey said.
Survey said.
Tonight, beginning at 5 p.m. Eastern, only on Game Show Network.
Paying bills has been difficult since my husband got hurt. Bill collectors called day and night. We thought of bankruptcy, but then a friend told us about Garden State.
Garden State is a nonprofit agency that works with your creditors to make an affordable payment plan for all your bills.
After speaking with our counselor, we save thousands of dollars in interest. Thank you, Garden State.
Get your bills together and call now for your free consultation. We can help you get out of debt. Call 1-800-99-BILLS.
Can I help you?
Yeah, I'd like you to bring some animals out to the house on Saturday.
Animals to your house?
Yeah, here's my address. About noon would be good. This is gonna be great. Hey!
Our customers are used to things coming to them. Because of Progressive Auto Insurance, our immediate response vehicles can come right to you, like a claims office on wheels.
We make getting back on the road fast and easy.
Visit Progressive.com or call us anytime at 1-800-PROGRESSIVE. and get competitive rates that could save you money.
See you on Saturday.
Call, click, or visit Progressive today.
Every day you can start to look younger just by cleaning your face. Pond's new age-defying cleansing towelettes. As dirt lifts, alpha hydroxys are deposited. Fine lines are visibly reduced to leave skin looking younger. From the Pond's Institute.
I gotta let you in on a little secret. Some of our best clients are already saving big. And we want you to start saving too. Why pay $4.99 a minute for psychic advice when we'll give it to you for less than $1 a minute? And you'll never call another 900 number again. You'll get your reading on a free 800 number, baby. You don't have to be psychic to see you saving money straight away.
Call 1-800-670-7061.
Yes, we are back with our champion. Robert, you've done it again. Congratulations to you.
Thank you, Bob.
Now, you know what happens? Every time you win more than $200, your wife comes running out here and checks your heart and your blood pressure and makes sure you're still alive.
Well, I hope so.
Well, let's see if you can't win a lot more, okay?
Good.
You're over $8,000 already, and the money you've won so far is yours to keep no matter what happens. But now we're going to give you new money to bet with. We'll start you on the bottom line with $200. You then bet your way across that bottom line by calling off high and low cards. When you get to the next row, we add another $400 to your betting money, and you bet your way across that line. Remember, minimum bets are $50 each time until you get to the top row. At that time, you must bet at least half of your dollars. And also, you'll have the opportunity to change one card on each line by choosing one of the extra cards, spare cards, that Lacey's dealing out over there. So you understand the rules? I know you do.
Yes, sir.
You've been here a lot of times.
Come on, let's
make these cards work for you. Ready?
It's about time.
Give him $200, please. Good luck, Robert.
Okay.
Turn that $200 into thousands, or your wife will come out here and attack your body.
Yee.
All right, here we go, Robert. It's a jack.
Oh, okay. 150
lower. 150 lower than the jack. The card is a six. You now got $350.
$200 higher.
200 higher. Remember, if another six comes up, it's a push in the big money cards. All right, 200 higher than the six. It's a jack. Look at there. 550.
400 lower.
400 lower than the jack. Your card's a six again. Jacks and sixes for you. You got $950, give you another $400, and I have $1,350. The six is your base, and you can play it or change it.
I'm going to keep it for now.
Keep the six. Okay.
And I'm going to bet $450 that it's higher.
$450 higher than the six. It is higher, yes. $1,800.
Change that card.
Okay, the 10 now becomes a 10 again. It's all right. $1,800.
$400 lower.
$400 lower than the 10. The card is an 8. Yes. Can't change it. You've already changed on this line. You got $2,200.
$200 higher.
$200 higher than the 8. It is a king. Yes. And look what you have. You have $2,400. You got to bet at least
$1,200. $2,400 lower.
$2,400. All of it, Robert.
All of it. Come on, get it!
Boy, she's really happy now.
Robert,
so far you've won $13,700 on card set.
Oh, I love it. That's better than small change.
Yes, it is better than small change. We'll be back in just a moment to meet a new challenger for this very nice man right after this.
I will not be afraid of the dark.
I will not feel guilty leaving my dog alone.
I will feel better about my dad living by himself.
I will know my children are safe.
I will go on vacation and finally be able to relax!
At ADT, we're always there.
helping more people feel safe in more ways than any other security company in America.
Brenda with ADT.
Call now and get ADT's sophisticated burglary system installed from just $99. Plus, get 2 months free monitoring when you call by July 31st.
I will live my life.
My life.
My life.
On my terms!
Call now and get an ADT burglary system from $99 installed. Plus, 2 months free monitoring. ADT. Always there.
Hi, Green Ball here. Be prepared to be bowled over by laughs, cash, and romance.
Newlywed Game Classic and the new Newlywed Game.
Together.
They make a great couple. Have a ball with a whole hour of Newlywed Games weeknights starting at 10 Eastern.
When I got my cholesterol checked, it was high. Too high. So Liz and I got very careful about what we were eating. We even joined a gym. But my doctor found my cholesterol was still too high.
He's doing everything you asked. Now what?
That's when my doctor added Lipitor.
Lipitor is the number one prescribed medication for lowering cholesterol. In clinical studies, Lipitor with diet lowered bad cholesterol 39 to 60%, total cholesterol 29 to 45%, triglycerides 19 to 37%. Once a day Lipitor is not for everyone, including people with liver disease or possible liver problems, women who are nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant. Blood tests are needed to check for liver problems. Tell your doctor about muscle pain or weakness as they may be signs of serious side effects. Call 1-888-LIPITOR.
Look at those numbers. They're way down.
Lipitor did it.
Ask your doctor what Lipitor can do for you. Lipitor, the lower numbers you're looking for.
Great, let's meet your new challenger. Bring that pretty lady in here. Woo,
woo. Hi, Robert, how are you?
Oh, my. Woo, is that what you said? Hi, Shelly.
Hi, Bob. I'm Shelly Forrester. I'm from Orange County, California. I'm a student at USC, and I'm graduating in May with a degree in economics.
Well, congratulations to you. It's nice to have you with us on Card
Talk. Thank you.
Did you cut the cards?
Yes, I did.
You did. All right, then Susanna will be dealing out the cards. We'll start from a brand new deck, by the way, and we'll start this match between you and Robert right now. Let's go to our first high-low question. Robert, we surveyed 100 men who subscribe to Playboy magazine. Uh-huh. You know what that is, don't you, Robert?
I heard of
okay.
it.
Okay. And we asked them, Robert, would you subscribe to Playboy if there were no nude pictures? How many men said that they would subscribe anyway?
I don't know what else they'd find in that stupid magazine, so I don't think there'd be many of them. I think they all buy it to look at those bodies.
Well, what's the matter with that?
Nothing.
Oh, okay.
But I don't have time or the money for Playboy magazine, but there are lots of guys that do. But if
you just won $13,000, what do you tell me you don't have time for Playboy?
I'm going to have more fun doing something else.
Oh. I'm not going to ask, folks. No way.
I don't.
How many out of 100 said they would?
I don't think over 35 of them would take it if they didn't have the
naked women. 35 out of 100 said they would subscribe even if there were no Playboy pictures or nude pictures. Shelly, higher or lower than 35?
Well, that's an interesting question, because my boyfriend's father subscribes to Playboy, and I know he gets it to look at the girls. Now, my boyfriend says that he reads it because he likes reading the articles. So...
then tell him to get Popular Mechanics.
Well, that might be a good idea. I'm going to say it's higher.
Higher than 35. The actual number of men who would subscribe to Playboy, even if there were no nude pictures, is 28. No, not higher. It was just a little bit lower. Okay, Robert, here's your base card in this game. Robert, it is a deuce.
It's
a
higher.
Higher than the deuce, it's a six.
Higher.
Higher than the six, your card is a three.
Boom. No.
That puts you back to your base of two, and Shelly gets a free shot at the card. Shelly, you didn't win the high-low, so you can't change it. You got to play off this card, and it's a three. Good card.
Higher.
Higher than the three, your card is a deuce.
Whoa.
Oh, mean card.
Tough deck.
My goodness, rough. You cut these cards, huh? Are they tough? Shelly, I've got a question for you. Shelly, we surveyed 100 top business executives across the country. We asked them, is your secretary a man? How many top business executives said their secretary is a man?
Well, based on the fact that I think most top executives are probably men, I think that most of their secretaries are going to be women. So I'm going to say that that's... Wait...
How many top executives said their secretary is a man?
Oh, that's going to be a really low number. I would say 10.
10?
Mm-hmm.
Robert, will it be higher or lower than 10?
I think along the same lines that this pretty lady does, and I'm going to say lower.
Lower. The actual number of top executives whose secretary is a man is zero. Zero. It was definitely lower. And Robert, again, you have the control, and there's your deuce. I know you don't want to change that.
Higher.
Higher than the two. The card is a two. Woo! My goodness. Shelly, you get a free shot. You got a three. Here we go.
Higher.
Higher than the three. It's a seven. Play
I'm
a freeze.
Freeze.
Freeze on there. She's going to protect her slight lead, to say the least. Okay. Another question for you. And this one is for Robert. We surveyed 100 married men, and we asked them, do you and your wife sleep in separate beds? How many men said they do sleep in separate beds, Robert?
I'm going to have to average that out as to how long they've been married.
What does that have to do with it?
After a certain number of years, one bed ain't enough for two people. The bones ache, and you got to spread them out a little. So I'm going to say that out of 100 married men, you're going to find 40 of them sleeping separate beds.
40. 40 said they sleep in separate beds. Shelly, higher or lower than 40?
I don't know any married people that sleep in separate beds.
Well, turn to your right there.
Well, I'm going to say it's lower.
Lower than 40? The actual number of men who said they and their wives sleep in separate beds is 12. You're right, Shelly. It was lower. All right, Shelly. You froze on the seven. You can change that card now.
I want to change that card.
And the seven is now. Oh. Where'd you get these cards? It's a seven.
I'm going to say higher.
Higher than the seven. It is Jack. Yes, higher.
I'm going to say lower.
Lower than the Jack. Your card is a five.
I'm going to say higher.
Higher. If you're right, you win game number one. It is. And Shelly, you're the winner of game number one. That's $100 in your pocket. And remember, it's the first contestant to win two games that plays the big money cards. We must pause. We'll be right back with more card sharks right after this. So don't go away.
1 hour. Two shows. Celebrities. Puzzles.
Oh, dear.
Solve.
The Price is Right.
It's Password Plus and Super Password tonight from 7 to 8 Eastern, only on Game Show Network.
Goodbye, Mr. Chip. Hello, Crispy Minis. Because once you try Crispy Minis rice snacks with their light, crispy crunch and intense flavors like cheddar and ranch, plain old chips seem a little flat. Quaker Crispy Minis, the rice snack that eats like a chip.
Bounty made napkins? Well, guess what? Bounty quilted napkins are finally here. The stronger, longer lasting napkin, Bounty.
New Faster Acting Dawn with Flash Sets. It powers through tough grease at a speed no other brand can touch. New Faster Acting Dawn. Get grease out of your way sooner.
I didn't want mail.
You don't have to sacrifice service to save money. Geico, a 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Want to see your piggy bank really grow? Geico. A 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Welcome back to Card Sharks. We're ready to start our second game. Shelly won the first game. Robert, you got to win this game to stay in the match. And Susanna's dealing out cards right now from the same deck, so let's start this game. And it goes to you, Shelly, the first question. Here it is. We surveyed 100 people and we asked them, if an illegal alien wins a state lottery, should he be allowed to keep the money? How many people said an illegal alien should be allowed to keep the money?
Well, I think he should be able to keep the money just because if we go to Canada or something like that and you play the lottery, you should be able to win. So I'm going to say that should be a relatively high number, about 85.
They didn't mind taking his money, did they? All right, 85. Robert, higher or lower than 85?
An illegal alien in this country really don't deserve too much of anything. I think he should earn it honestly. And I'm going to say that number is going to be considerable lower.
Lower, you say? Actual number of people who said an illegal alien should be allowed to keep the money is considerably lower, 42. You're right, Robert. Now, Robert, you've got to win this game in order to tie it up. Let's see if you do. Here's your card. It's a 9. Player change.
Change that.
Change that 9. Your new card is a 9 again.
In that event, I've got to go lower.
Lower than the 9. We're going to burn this deck. Woo! It's a 9. No! Where'd you get these?
I don't know, Bob.
Where'd I get the guy that shuffled them?
Shelly, you get a free shot at the cards. If it's a 9, I'm leaving, you know? Yeah! See you, folks. And you gotta play, Shelly. If another 9 comes up, I demand a recount.
I'm gonna say lower.
What'd you say?
Lower.
Lower than the 9. Your card is a king. We could be here until day after tomorrow with this game. You know that. Okay, let's go again. Another high-low question for Robert. We surveyed 100 single women, and we asked them, would you marry a man who insisted his mother live under the same roof with you? How many single women would marry this turkey anyway?
Oh, boy. Well, you're going to find some of them that are so desperate to get married they'd put up with anything.
Is that right?
But
how many then?
Not too many. 21.
21. Will it be higher or lower than 21 single women who would marry him anyway, Shelly?
I think it's going to be lower.
Lower than 21? The actual number of single women who would marry a man who insisted his mother live with them is 30. Not lower, it was higher. Again, Robert. Now, you can change that 9.
Change that 9?
Yes, indeed. The 9 now becomes a 10.
Lower.
Lower than the 10, it is a king. Shelly gets a free shot off the 9.
Higher.
Higher than the 9, it is a queen.
Lower.
Lower than the queen, it's a 6.
Higher.
Higher than the 6. It's a king.
Lower.
Lower for the championship. Yes, there you are. We have a new champion.
How about that?
Congratulations, Shelly.
Thank you.
Robert, I want to tell you something, okay?
Right.
I've been doing game shows for about 20 years, and you are one of the most delightful human beings I've ever met. Thank you for being with us. $13,700. Goodbye, my friend. We'll see you again. Okay?
Come here,
Shelly. Right around here. This is our new champion, and we're going to give her a chance to win thousands of dollars when she plays the big money cards right after these words.
A big deal is coming August 27th.
You got your turkey.
What?
Sliced and smoked.
You got your bacon strips.
Uh-huh.
I'm getting stoked. There's mozzarella. And also cheddar. All melting there together. Nothing better, nothing better. You got your turkey. Sliced and smoked.
What?
You got your bacon.
Jay Bush here at the Old Bush Family Farm to introduce our new country-style baked beans. Roll that new beautiful bean footage.
They're slow cooked with extra brown sugar and hickory smoked bacon, so the sauce is thicker and the flavor is richer.
The secret family recipe is known only to me and my dog, Duke. And I know I can trust him.
Okay, let's start the bidding on the secret family recipe. How about a seven of you in the corner, seven of a lady in the back, seven of a man with a hand
up. Duke. Uh-oh. Try Bush's new country-style baked beans.
Mounds and Almond Joy, because everybody needs a five-minute vacation.
Hi, I'm Wilford Brimley, and I've had diabetes for about 20 years. I stay active, and I feel pretty good most of the time. See, I do a few simple things now. I'm not perfect, but I try and watch my diet and exercise, and I check my blood sugar. And I get all my diabetic testing supplies from Liberty Medical. If you're 65 or over and on Medicare, call Liberty. They can help you live a better life. Hundreds of thousands of people trust Liberty. They're the nation's leader in home delivery of diabetic testing supplies. bring everything you need right to your door. Fill out your insurance forms, even bill Medicare or your insurance company, and you pay no money up front. Oh, and they carry all the brands. If you have diabetes, you check your blood sugar and you check it often. There's no reason not to. And call Liberty. They can help you live a better life.
Hey, watch this. Richard Dawson kisses and tells, but Ray Combs keeps his lips to himself in back-to-back episodes of Family Feud, followed by $100,000 Pyramid.
We're out of time. That means that we're going to give you a chance to play the big money cards when we come back tomorrow. Until then, I'm Bob Eubanks and Lacey Pemberton, Susanna Williams, Shelley, Gene Wood, and the gang saying, see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Some of our departing contestants will receive a gift certificate from Sears Spring Summer Catalog with over 1,200 pages of ideas. 1-800-453-7000. And a pocket radio. And from out of the ocean comes a unique blended seafood, new delicacies, now in the frozen food section. And a cookbook. And new Italian herb shake and bake coating mix, Parmesan cheese and great seasonings making a delicious new recipe for crispy chicken, Italian style. And a member of our studio audience will receive Bernardo Limoges, four-place setting of Artois dinnerware, elegant china enhanced by traditional design, interpreted for today's lifestyle from Bernardo Limoges. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Shark. A Mark Goodson Television Production.
From Hollywood, it's everybody's game of strategy, knowledge, and fun. It's Tic-Tac-Toe. And now, here's our host, Jim Caldwell.
Hey, thank you very much. Oh, terrific. What a great audience. All right. Hey, welcome to another edition of Tic-Tac-Toe. Today we're going to be, no doubt, giving away some money. We do that every day here on Tic-Tac-Toe, but we need two players to do it. Our current champion's really on a roll, doing a great job. Let's bring out her and her challenger right now. Charlie?
Well, Jim, our current champion is a manager whose interests include travel and sports. Her winnings total in cash and prizes, $9,550, McClaire Delaman. And her opponent is the winner of the Tic-Tac-Toe Dallas contestant search. He's a supervisor whose interests include languages and racquetball, made Paul Donsbach.
Hi, Paul. Welcome to Tic-Tac-Toe.
Thank you. I'm very excited to be here.
I suspect you are. I should remind everybody that Paul is the winner of the Tic-Tac-Toe Dallas contestant search, given on or sponsored by KXTX TV 39. I bet that was quite a process to go through, wasn't it?
Well, I owe it all to my wife, Carol.
What do you mean by that?
The producers came to Dallas looking for a contestant, and she sent in the postcard and came down on the day of the contest and stayed with me the whole day for moral support.
Gave you that all-important moral support. That's terrific. Is she here today? Did she come out with you?
Yes, she's right there in the front row.
Point her out to us.
It's Carol, my new bride.
Terrific, and congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm sure that Carol and all of the viewers, of course, KXDX, are going to be giving you lots of support. That's Wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Paul, welcome back, Claire.
Hi, Jim. It's nice to be here.
I know it is. You've been doing really well here on the show. You had some trouble getting here, didn't you?
My car broke down the last time I was on the way to the studio, and I was really glad to get here so easily today and to have won a little money so I can get the darn car repaired.
I know it means a lot, and if you do well here on the show, maybe you'll end up driving away in a brand new car.
Oh,
you never know, right?
That would be so great.
Well, so far you've picked up $9,550. Let's get back to Tic-Tac-Toe and start a brand new game. Paul Donsbach and Claire Delaman are the players. All right, let's take a look at the nine categories for this game. Here they are. Sex symbols, it's a dilemma. Poetry, animal stars, strange facts, seesaw, famous sights, number please, and dropouts. And remember, those red boxes are special categories, and I'll be sure to describe them if we get to them. All right, Claire, you're the champ. Go ahead and start us off.
Well, Jim, I've always been accused of knowing a lot of strange things, so I'd like to try strange facts in the center box, please.
All right, I'll read you this question, Claire, and you'll have some extra time to think it over. Now, this famous bridge was completed in 1831. In 1967, it was dismantled because it was sinking into the River Thames and was rebuilt piece by piece in the western United States. Two parts. Number one, name the bridge, and also name the state where it was rebuilt. Here's your extra time. All right, Claire, strange facts is the category. It's worth $300. Center box question. Now, this famous bridge was completed in 1831. In 1967, it was dismantled because it was sinking into the River Thames. It was rebuilt piece by piece in the western United States. Now, name the bridge.
London Bridge.
That's right. Now, number two, name the state where it was rebuilt.
Arizona.
You have the center box. Havasu City, right next to Lake Havasu. All right, center box gets an X, $300 pot. Let's go ahead and shuffle. All right, Paul.
I'd like to go with strange facts in the top left.
All right, let's see how well you do in this category this time. Although the capital of Alaska has only about 20,000 residents, the city limits include more than 3,000 square miles of land, making this city, in terms of area, the largest in America. Name that city.
Juneau.
Right you are. All right, strange facts get to know this time. $500 pot. We're going to take a break and come back after these words.
Hi, I'm Alan Thicke, host of All New Three's a Crowd, and there's
we just started a brand new game between our champion Claire Delaman and her challenger Paul Donsbach, who of course is our contestant search winner from Dallas, Texas. And we're off and running with an O and X on the board, $500 pot. Let's shuffle. Claire, your turn.
I'd like to try famous sights in the upper right, please.
Okay. Claire, take a look at this picture. This famous chapel stands on the grounds of one of America's service academies. Name that branch of the armed forces.
The Air Force.
Right. Of course, it's a beautiful chapel on the grounds of the United States Air Force Academy, where I spent some time way back when. All right, Claire, famous sights gets an O. Excuse me, an X. $700 pot. Let's shuffle. Paul.
I'd like number, please, in the bottom left for the block.
All right, going for a block, Paul, but because it's a special category, you're both going to play. You want a block. Claire, if you get this box, you'll win your third game of tic-tac-doe. Now, listen carefully. In the news, we always hear about the U.S. importing millions of barrels of oil. But how many gallons are in a barrel of oil? Paul, if you can give me the exact number, you'll win the box and have a block automatically.
100.
No, 100 is not the exact number, Paul, but you can still get the box. Claire, do you think the exact number of gallons in a barrel of oil is higher or lower than 100 gallons? Remember, a right answer from you and you'll win the game. A wrong answer? Paul, have a block.
Lower.
Claire, the exact number is 42. That's lower. You win! Claire, I tell you, you looked like you were guessing on that, were you?
A pure guess. I had no idea.
Well, you guessed in the right direction. Of course, 42 gallons of oil in a barrel of oil, a diagonal tic-tac-doe, $900 added to your previous winnings. In cash and prizes, your total now, Claire, is $10,450. We congratulate you, Claire.
Thank you.
We're going to find out how well you do against the dragon here in just one moment. But first, Paul Donsbach. I tell you, a contestant search winner from Dallas, Texas, sometimes it works out this way. We're sorry it went so fast.
I'm having a good time.
Well, we sure are glad you did. And, of course, we want to thank KXTX Channel TV 39 in Dallas for putting on their contestant search and having you come out and spend some time with us. Glad you had a good time, Paul.
Thank you.
Some parting gifts. Good luck to you and your wife.
Okay.
All right, Claire, we're going to find out how well you do against the dragon. You ready?
I'm ready.
Come on over. Let's play the bonus game. Well, you've done this before.
I've done this before, but it's always a little nerve-wracking.
Well, let's find out how it goes. Of course, behind these numbers are various amounts of money. There's a tick and a tack and the good old dragon. You want to get a tick and the tack or $1,000 or more, and Charlie O'Donnell's going to tell you what you will win.
Well, Claire, you'll want to give three cheers for these skits that will provide you with three chairs. First, Claire, you'll be sitting pretty in your living room, ensconced in this comfortable recliner. A recliner rocker chair from Lazy Boy Chair Company. Enjoy genuine Lazy Boy quality and comfort as you rock or recline. Relax, it's from Lazy Boy. Then you'll relax in your backyard in a chaise lounge, part of this great patio furniture. Selected with a $300 gift certificate from JT's General Store. Select from fashions, housewares, and much more in the JT's General Store Spring 1986 in-home shopping catalog. And finally, Claire, on vacation, you'll sit back for a ride in an unusual kind of chair as you take a rickshaw through the streets of exotic Hong Kong! Known as the Jewel of the Orient, Hong Kong is famous for its exotic cuisine, silk, jade, and legendary harbor. Myriad attractions await you in this cosmopolitan colony on the southern tip of China. In this crossroads city of the Orient, you'll enjoy a blend of cultures where East meets West in a burst of color. You'll stay at the Harbor View Holiday Inn, Hong Kong. New deluxe waterfront hotel with panoramic views of Hong Kong Harbor in the middle of all the shopping, nightlife, and entertainment that the exotic Orient can offer. This three chairs package is worth in cash and prizes over $3,800.
I heard you literally scream. You want to go to Hong Kong, huh?
I have always wanted to go to Hong Kong.
Well, you got to beat the dragon. You got to avoid him at all costs. Get the tick and the tack, you'll get the dough automatically. You ready to go?
I'm ready.
Okay, he's found a place to hide. You want some help from the audience?
My friend Chris is out there.
All right, Chris.
Any suggestions, Chris? Three. Let's
try number three. All right, let's find out what's there. Behind three. Tick.
Tick.
Okay.
Very good.
That's a nice start. All you need is a tack and $1,000.
I see a lot of number fours out there.
Number four, you want to go for it?
Let's try number four.
Okay, three and then four. 300.
300.
All right. Need 700 or attack.
I see a very excited man with five fingers up there, so let's try five.
All right, let's try and take a look at a very excited five. 400. Okay. You're up to 700 now. Just 300 or attack.
There's a lot of eights out there. Try number eight.
All right, number eight. Tack, you're going to Hong Kong. Oh, it's good. Going to Hong Kong. All right, let's find out where the dragon was hiding at. Where did he? Behind number six. All right, you got the tick and the tack. Terrific.
Hong Kong.
1,000 in dough is yours. A great trip to Hong Kong. Your total now in cash and prizes. Can you read that over there?
$14,250.
That's right. Well, we're going to find out who your next challenge is going to be right after we take this break. Don't go away. Hey.
Well, hello there.
He was born a country boy.
All now. Call 1-800-203-2400 to order Elvis Country for $19.99 for two CDs or two cassettes, plus $3.99 shipping and handling. Or send check or money order to Elvis Country, Department 8, Richmond, Virginia, 23280. Call 1-800-203-2400 or order online at timelife.com.
Hi, this is Jeff Tate with Queensrÿche. Don't miss Rock and Roll Jeopardy on Game Show Network. This game rocks.
Rock and Roll Jeopardy, today, 12:30 Eastern, 9:30 Pacific.
Back to you, Jim.
Thank you, Charlie. Well, our current champion has defeated the dragon no less than three times in a row. Three for three, Claire, pretty good.
I've been pretty lucky, Jim, and a good audience helping me out with the numbers.
Well, I know we always have a great audience, and now it's time to see, Claire, who your next challenger is going to be. You ready for that?
I'm ready.
All right, Charlie, bring her out for us.
Well, Jim, she's a promotions representative who once worked for a pro basketball team. Meet Chandra Pizzullo.
Hi, Chandra.
Hi, Chandra. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
What do you promote?
Sports shoes. I travel around the Southwest coordinating events, which in turn promote the shoes.
Sounds like interesting work. You get to travel quite a bit.
Uh-huh.
And you once worked for a pro basketball team?
I was an intern with the then San Diego Clippers. Got my start as a freelance photographer. Got to sit on the floor during the athletic events and get close to the players. And the more I did, the more I respected their abilities. It was a terrific experience.
You know, I must say with basketball players, I've always looked up to them myself. And, you know, I have to respect their ability just like you. Chandra, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
We have nine brand new categories that we have to take a look at right this very moment. Here they are. Numero uno, showdown, chemistry, comic strips, quotes, auction, TV stars, opponent's choice, and who am I? Those are the nine categories. Claire, you're the champ. Lead us off.
I'd like to try quotes in the middle, Jim.
All right, let's find out what that's all about. It's a two-part question, Claire. You'll have some extra time. Now, one of this great American's most famous lines comes from a document that he composed almost single-handedly. The famous quote is, "We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal." Two parts. Name the man who wrote those famous words, and also name the document. Here's your extra time. Clara, one of this great American's most famous lines comes from a document that he composed almost single-handedly. The famous quote is, "We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal." Name the man who wrote those famous words.
Thomas Jefferson.
Right. Part two, name the document.
The Declaration of Independence.
You have the center box. All right, Claire, quotes gets an X. Let's go ahead and shuffle now with the $300 pots. Over to you, Chandra.
I'd like to go with chemistry in the upper left.
Chandra, it goes like this. In 1909, a Danish chemist invented this numerical scale, which indicates whether a chemical is an acid or a base. Now, the scale runs from 0 to 14, with water being assigned the neutral number 7. What is the two-letter name given to that scale?
The pH scale.
Right. The pH factor of scale. Top left gets an O, $500 pot. Time for us to take a break. We're going to be back. Don't go away.
Show Network celebrates Feud 25, the Family Feud 25th anniversary, by counting down the 25 greatest feud moments during an entire night of classic episodes. And you've never seen the feud quite like this.
I think this might be an interesting day.
Feud 25, the Family Feud 25th anniversary, tomorrow at 8 Eastern, only on Game Show Network.
You are amazing. Is there anything you can't do?
Your baby's growing quickly. He needs 50% more calcium by the time he's 4 months. That's why there's Carnation Follow-Up with extra calcium. Carnation Follow-Up from Nestle.
Take away the sexy clothes and underwear and put on the silkiest thing of all, Caress Silkening Body Lotion. It can make every woman feel even more beautiful. Before you dress, Caress.
Here at Physicians Mutual and Physicians Life,
we're now offering you a wider range of insurance
to suit your changing way of life.
From hospital plans
to outpatient protection.
From Medicare supplement policies
to home health care coverage.
From guaranteed life insurance
to innovative annuities.
We're working harder than ever
to develop the kind of protection you need today
and in the future.
It's part of our ongoing commitment
to provide you with the quality,
the value,
and above all, the service you deserve.
Physicians Mutual Insurance Company.
We've been here when you needed us for nearly 100 years.
And we'll be here when you need us for 100 more.
For more information, call us toll free.
Day or night.
We'll be happy to help you in any way.
That's a promise.
Now, more than ever,
we're here when you need us.
Welcome back. We have a game going between Chandra and our champion, Claire. Claire, you're in game number four. How are you doing so far?
Well, I'm doing pretty good so far, Jim.
So far, so good, as they say. Chandra, this is, let me see, you have one question under your belt. Are you kind of relaxed?
And... I'm feeling real good. I'm ready to play.
All right, let's get back to it. $500 pot. And Claire, it's your turn.
I'd like to try TV stars in the upper middle, please.
Claire, take a look at this picture. Now, this veteran TV comedy star is shown here in a dramatic role in the 1985 movie Stone Pillow. Name her.
Lucille Ball.
Right. One talented lady, I might add. She's done just about everything. TV stars gets an X. $700 pot. Let's shuffle. Chandra?
Well, it looks like I'm going to have to go with opponent's choice for the block.
All right, Chandra, in the opponent's choice category, Claire is going to decide whether you're going to answer two questions on comedians or one on King Arthur. Which will it be, Claire?
Well, let's try two on comedians.
All right, Chandra, going for a block, here is your first question of two under comedians. Name the comedian who starred in the films Best Defense and 48 Hours.
Murphy.
Right, Eddie Murphy. All right, number two. Name the insult comedian who has earned himself the nicknames Mr. Warmth and the Merchant of Venom.
Don Rickles?
You have a block.
That's good.
That's about it. All right, Chandra, put an O on the board for a successful block. We now have a $900 pot. Time to shuffle. Five boxes remain. Back to you, Claire.
Let's try quotes in the lower left, Jim.
Here we are again, this category for you in this game. In 1898, a U.S. Navy squadron streamed into the harbor of
Excuse me, Jim, that's steamed into the harbor.
All right, let's start over. In 1898, a U.S. Navy squadron steamed into the harbor of this Asian island nation. Commodore George Dewey gave his famous command, "You may fire when ready, Gridley," and 10 Spanish men of war sank beneath the sea. Name the island nation where that battle took place.
The Philippines.
Right. Nicely done, Claire. Good for you. Quotes gets an X. We now have a $1,100 pot. Four boxes left. Let's shuffle. Chandra.
Comic strips in the upper right, please.
First time in this category. Going for a block, Chandra. This popular comic strip featured a young knight who eventually becomes a member of King Arthur's Round Table. In 1954, the strip was turned into a movie starring Robert Wagner. For a block. Name the strip. I have a feeling Claire knows the answer. What do you think it is, Claire?
Prince Valiant.
That's right, Prince Valiant. Okay. All right, box goes unclaimed. $1,100 pot. Let's shuffle again. Claire.
Ugh. Well, I'd like to try auction in the upper right for the win.
Claire, you're going for your fourth game of tic-tac-toe if you earn this box, but the auction category is a special one. You both get to play. Chandra, if you get this box, you'll have a block. Now, you both will bid on how many correct answers you can give to this question. And remember, high bidder gets control. There are seven countries in the world which are far enough north to lie partially above the Arctic Circle. How many of those cold countries can you name? Claire, you chose the category. The bidding starts with you.
Four.
Four. All right, Chandra, would you like to say five?
Yes, I'd like to try five.
All right, Claire, can you top that?
Go ahead, Chandra.
Okay. All right, Chandra, in order for you to have a block with this question, you have to make your bid of five. And remember, we're talking about seven countries in the world which are far enough north to lie partially above the Arctic Circle. You must name five. Go.
The United States.
That's one.
Canada.
Canada is another.
Soviet Union?
Correct.
Finland?
Finland's another one. Give me one more, you'll have a block.
Sweden.
That's right, you have a block. Good job, Chandra. You obviously know your geography. You just rattled those right off. The other two on this list, Denmark or Greenland. I didn't know that Denmark and Greenland are part of the same thing there. I think Denmark rides with Greenland, however you would say that. They're together. And Norway. That's the other one. Okay, we put the O on the board for a block. We have a $1,300 pot. Let's shuffle. Chandra, it's your turn.
I'd like to go with comic strips, please.
Chandra, this popular comic strip by Mel Lazarus deals with the exasperation and worry a doting mother feels for her three grown-up children and her children's irritation at her constant meddling in their lives. Name that comic strip.
Mama.
Mama's right. Comic strip gets an O. $1,500 in the pot and just two boxes remain. We're going to take a break and come right back.
You got your turkey.
What? Sliced and smoked.
And Children's Fund is America's oldest and most trusted child sponsorship charity because so much of your money goes right where it belongs, to the children who need it.
Hey, watch this. Cancel your trip to Vegas. Catch card sharks instead. Then take a spin with Vanna on Wheel of Fortune, followed by Jeopardy.
At this critical time, we have to end it right now and pick it up on our next show. Claire, nice to meet you. Wish you good luck next time.
Thank you.
Claire, you're the champion. You're going to be coming back with $14,250. Good luck to both of you. I'm Jim Caldwell. See you in our next Tic Tac Bill.
Some of our departing contestants will receive the more you hear, the more you read, the more you ask your doctor. You'll know why Bayer is the wonder drug that works wonders. Plus,
Hollywood Safflower Oil introduces calorie-counting sprayers. Just 1.5 calories in each spray, and they're free from Hollywood Oil. Details on specially marked bottles.
Ladies and gentlemen, the original, the one that started it all, Tidy Bowl. Tidy Bowl, one sparkling performance after another.
The stakes are high.
One mistake and Chris retains the championship.
So it pays to go slow.
Freeze right there.
Play your cards right.
I'll try it higher.
And you might win the show.
Lower than the queen.
Yes!
Yeah! Ah!
On Card Sharks, Wild Game, Witty Poetry. Next on Game Show Network.
Tic-Tac-Toe is a Jack Barry and Dan Enright production.
It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Henson family. Lauren, Darla, Richard, Karen, and Juanita, ready for action. And the Morrison.